Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you today? Me? I'm doing spectacularly because this is an important day in our vlog, in our 21st episode now on growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers. And we crossed a pretty important milestone yesterday. We passed the 25,000 subscriber mark, which I am thrilled with. But when I stop and think about our goal is to reach 100,000 subscribers in the year 2014, we're 5 months in. It's looking kind of bleak as far as reaching the 100,000 subscribers, but I'm not discouraged in any way, shape, or form because this journey was about discovering if a content creator can make a living and what we have to do to make a living using YouTube as a base for creating content. And as far as that goes, I think we're on the road to some pretty good success. So I thought this would be an ideal time to kind of recap and take a look at what we've learned, some of the changes in direction that we've made since we began. Now, it wasn't that long ago, 21 episodes ago, that I posted my first video and this vlog. And I'm looking, the posting date here was March the 4th. So March. So it's only 2.5 months ago or so that I posted the first one. And if I look there, yeah, I can see, you probably can't see it, but I had just under 12,000 subscribers at that point. So we've more than doubled the number of subscribers in the last 2 months that we had, which is a great ratio. And we had some really great ramping up, some really good traction. We've had lots of success, and we've had a few things that have been not quite as successful. And we've changed direction at least one major way in that 2 months. And I've really gained one different level of appreciation since that all began. I think I understood when we began this journey that YouTube was a social network, but I didn't realize how much of a social network YouTube was. When I started to engage and started this vlog, I had a fairly decent level of engagement with the audience through Google Plus chat or the comments area in YouTube, but that has increased dramatically over the last little while. And I've started to engage more in the Google Plus community just in the last, even in a shorter frame of time, and starting to recognize just how that is becoming a real key in how we grow our channel and how we engage with our audience. Because I guess as you decide how you're going to grow your own channel, you have to decide whether you're going to grow with real relationships or you're just going to grow by massively reaching out. You know, the people who have huge viral success where their videos take off overnight and they suddenly have hundreds of thousands of subscribers, it's very difficult for them to have an opportunity to engage one-on-one and actually have a lot of conversations with their subscribers and their followers, just because there are so many of them and their bandwidth is limited. When you grow strategically the way that our channel is growing, we have an opportunity to actually forge relationships with the individuals that are following us, and they become champions as well. So I can see the effect of having conversations, and the people who have conversations with when they share videos with others and when they comment, when they plus the posts, especially in the Google Plus space, as it reaches out across those into other people's networks and we are suddenly exposed to other people, I'm really recognizing how valuable that engagement is. And the cool thing about engaging and growing strategically on YouTube that I don't think that the viral growth people get advantage of, I don't mean that they don't understand it, I mean that they don't build the advantage of, is the loyalty that is generated as a result of you growing with your audience. And there's no place that I recognize that more profoundly than in our Patreon campaign. As we a month ago changed track or added a revenue channel, saying that I wasn't going to go for corporate sponsorship, which was always an option. As I looked at growing the channel out, and my first goal was to get a critical mass where I was relevant in YouTube, where people would notice me and where I would walk in and talk to somebody and say, and I wouldn't have to say, I've got 300 subscribers, but they're really good. But I didn't know what the number was coming out of my mouth that would make me feel like the channel was an entity that was worth considering, but I knew it wasn't 1,000 and it wasn't 10,000. I knew it had to be larger. And I'm starting to feel that when I hear the word 25,000 come out of my mouth, it has a little more weight. It carries a little more weight. And this isn't to belittle any channels that are beneath or glorify any channels that have more as far as the engagement. This is my personal market that I'm growing and what it's going to require with the sort of followers I have in order to make a living. Very successful YouTube channel can be 300 or 400 subscribers. depending on what your goals are, which we've talked about in the past. So this is in no means meant to overly glorify what we've done, nor to diminish any efforts that are being made out there. But having said that, I knew that I was reaching the point where I could go and I could start to speak to sponsors about coming on board to the channel, and I could start bringing in additional revenue. And to be honest, I was not looking forward to that point, because that's what I did for 15 years when I did network television. I spent about 60% of my time dealing with my sponsors and being concerned and following their businesses closely and being very sensitive to every little up and down in their business cycle and worrying how it would affect me. I spend a tremendous amount of time and energy just getting the money to keep the doors open on the TV show. And while it was necessary, there wasn't a lot of joy in that. I enjoyed the relationships, but I didn't enjoy that work. So I was kind of looking at that next phase in our growth with some trepidation. I mean, I knew that AdSense revenue would at some point be relevant and be enough to really help keep the doors open. And we are trending in a good direction. You know, we're now making well over $1,000 each and every month based on 25,000 subscribers with AdSense revenue, which is good. When we hit 100,000 subscribers, it'll be a nice chunk of change flowing in. So that's going to be great, but it's not enough to kind of keep the doors open. And it's certainly not enough to retire on at this point. So we were going to have to find some additional sources of revenue, and corporate sponsorship is the most likely candidate. And then a friend of mine, John Beeler, who is actually quite solid in the maker community, he told me about Patreon. And I looked at Patreon for a good month and a half, and I followed it, and I looked at the success that different individuals had had, and decided that I was going to try for Camelot. I was going to say, I'm not going to go for any corporate sponsors. I'm going to trust my community, which I feel this engagement with, and I'm going to see if they will indeed support us. And I'm thrilled. You know, when we launched the campaign, we immediately had about 80 people, 85 people sign up in the first couple of days. We are now 3-4 weeks into the campaign, and we're up to $400 a month, a little bit north of $400 a month, which again, I'm not going to be able to retire on, but it's growing steadily. Each and every week, we get more people coming on, and we don't push it too hard, although it might sound like I'm pushing it hard now because I'm talking about it so much in this. But the reason I'm talking about it here is so that you can understand that your community can become the resource for you if you communicate to them an appropriate message. Patreon might not be for every YouTube channel. It certainly isn't for every YouTube channel. But my community, I believe, recognizes that I could spend 40, 50, 60% of my time out raising money for the channel that I can now spend creating content for the channel, which means that I create more content, which gives them more information that they trust me to provide. So that's the relationship that I believe is now being built through Patreon, and I couldn't be happier. Patreon is the biggest surprise for me in the last 2 months, 2.5 months since we started this vlog. I didn't expect that crowdfunding would be a source of revenue that I would really embrace personally. I've never been good at asking for money. That's one of the reasons I don't do a great job on selling courses and stuff. So putting together a pitch, putting together this page here that you see here, asking for support on Patreon, that was a lot of work for me. That was a big challenge. But as I say, I couldn't be happier with how it's coming together. And it's something that we'll return to and visit as we try different things. And as I start to learn from my audience, where I'm making wins, where I'm doing a good job, and where I'm making mistakes. The nice thing about it is it's a fairly small community. You know they're all supporting you, so your ears better be big ears when they're talking to you. So I have my email flagged so that as soon as a message comes in from the Patreon page, it pops to the very top of my list of priorities, and I respond to it immediately as well. Some of the other changes that have happened since we began is I used to do a radio program, a weekly radio program, here and just in the Lower Mainland area, and then it was podcast. Many of you could be subscribers to that as well, and it was just a general interest technology show. And I kept it going to be in mainstream media, but we stopped doing it 2 weeks ago, and it came to the end of its last contract. The sponsors weren't sure that they were quite getting the same value in the radio space as they get from some of their online ventures and that sort of stuff. And so it just seemed a natural time to put it out of its misery. And it wasn't miserable. I shouldn't say put it out of its misery. To set it out to pasture, shall we say. But I wasn't willing to let go of having a weekly live show that I could talk to fascinating and interesting people about a wide variety of topics. So as I saw it winding down, I was really thinking about what I could do with the next generation of my radio show. And for me, this is a huge thing because for over 20 years, I have had a mainstream media product that I've worked on. A TV series. We were on television for 17 years total. A newspaper columnist I wrote newspaper columns for, I think, 10 or 12 years. And I've had radio shows all through that period as well. So I've never been without a mainstream traditional media avenue, a way to communicate it, a way to share through mainstream media. And now, I don't. For the first time, I'm completely an online guy. So that's a big change for me. What I decided to do with our show is I decided to really test out the Google Hangouts space and to move it into Google Hangouts and to take advantage of Google Hangouts on air and see if I could create a fully interactive show, allowing my audience to really participate and to reach out to a lot of different guests and to create some nice energy that's just beyond what we were doing with a radio podcast, just with interviews and that sort of stuff, which is all fine and dandy. It's great. But I wanted to do a little bit more. I wanted to push the boundaries a little bit. And so I'd recently licensed a product called Webinar Jam, which is a piece of software which kind of puts a shell over top of Google Hangouts. And it's designed for webinars. It's really designed for the internet marketing side of webinars where you're trying to sell something out of the back end because they've got all these great little calls to action and the things that you can put in and you can insert in the chat area of the webinar and make offers to people with live links right within the webinar itself, which I think is a great concept. And I thought I could take those communication tools and migrate them into the world of an online radio show or a webcast and take advantage of those tools. So we're in the midst of testing that out. We just ran our first test last night. It was fairly successful. You know, the quality, the biggest issue that I really have with the whole Google Hangout thing is that video quality just doesn't quite cut it, does it? And plus the fact they got those stupid little hats and things that sometimes guests play with. But I digress. The video quality, I've got to work on trying to figure out how to make that a little bit better. It's great for an audio podcast. It's great for recording an audio podcast. The audio quality, not great, but I've been reading and I think I can improve the quality by going into something called studio mode, which I'll learn more about over the next little while. But I can also do that. I can also increase the audio quality by having everybody locally record, then combining those files at the end and marrying them all together. So there are ways around improving the audio quality. I'm not sure we're going to be able to improve the video quality enough to make it get to where I want it to be. That doesn't mean that it won't be a viable product. But that now fills out my different playlist mix that's on the channel. I don't think I'll be adding anything new after this. So we're going to be bringing that show into a playlist in the Dotto Tech channel, which again should help drive my YouTube subscriber base because I'm going to be pointing everybody that used to be pointed towards podcasts. I'm going to be as much as possible trying to get them to view them as webcasts on YouTube. So a little bit rambly today as far as the content goes, but I did want to talk to you about the biggest things that I'd learned over the last couple of months is since we started posting this vlog. And since we hit a milestone, it seemed like a good time to have that conversation. So the biggest things that I learned are looking for new revenue opportunities, Patreon coming up. Don't ignore the fact that crowdfunding might be the answer. Second thing is really pay attention to what's happening with your social network side of YouTube. How much conversation, how much dialogue, how much engagement you can create with your audience. And if you are a channel of similar size to mine and, you know, in the tens of thousands, you can certainly have a great relationship with a large percentage of your subscribers, empowering them, making them feel validated, learning from them, and using them as champions to go out and grow your network. And the people that they bring, and they themselves, become staunch supporters. They aren't just watching for a little while and going away. You're going to see the results in immediate traffic, immediate traction for all of your videos, getting viewed and getting grabbed and getting taken up and having comments on them right away as soon as you post them, which is incredibly gratifying as a content creator. With that, I'm going to wrap things up for today. As I mentioned, we have a Patreon campaign. If you're interested in supporting us and seeing that we continue, the best way you can do that is by becoming a patron of Dotto Tech. So check out our Patreon page and see exactly how we've positioned it. And even if you're not interested in supporting us, take a look at how we've positioned it, and you might learn something from that for your own channel. So I encourage you to take a look at that. As well, of course, I would love you to subscribe to this channel, and also you can sign up for our newsletter, which includes a digest of all of the videos we produce, but also notification of any webinars and special events that we have coming up. And we are producing at least one webinar on different productivity or technology related topics per month, which are doing quite well. We're really having a lot of fun with our webinars as well. So with that, thank you very much for spending time with me today. I appreciate you spending some of that valuable time with me. I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.